Hello and a very good evening. You're watching Verdict 2017 on Rajya Sabha Television with me, Frank Pereira. Here are this evening's Verdict headlines. Campaigning ends for the first phase of UP elections on February 11th. Elections for 73 seats spread across 15 districts in the western part of the state to be held on February 11th. Top leaders of BJP and the Congress campaign in Uttarakhand for the February 15th elections. BJP Chief Amit Shah, Congress leaders Rahul Gandhi and Chief Minister Harish Rawat address rallies. Re-polling held in 48 polling stations in 5 districts of Punjab including Amritsar, Moga, Muktsar, Mansa and Sangrur. Election Commission ordered re-elections after paper audit trail and electronic voting machines malfunctioned on February 4th. While campaigning for the first phase of polling in Uttar Pradesh for 73 seats came to an end on Thursday. The seats are spread across 15 districts in the western part of the state, including Muzaffarnagar and Shamli. The other districts which are going to polls in this phase are Baghpat, Meerut, Ghaziabad, Hapur, Bulandshahr, Aligarh, Mathura, Hathras and Agra. There are 2.57 crore eligible voters in the first phase, which includes more than 24 lakh first-time voters. Stakes are high for all parties as this phase is likely to set the tone for the elections in the remaining 6 phases. There will be more phases to elect candidates for 403 assembly seats, counting for which will be held on March 11th. The high-voltage political campaigning for the first phase of the Uttar Pradesh elections ended this evening. Leaders of the BJP, BSP and SP Congress Alliance and other smaller parties held rallies in different parts of the state. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Akhilesh Yadav addressed rallies in Mathura, Hathras, Agra and Firozabad. He said that the Samajwadi Party will create history by retaining power in the state. Taking a dig at Mayawati, he said her party will only end up building more elephant monuments in the state. Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi targeted Prime Minister Narendra Modi for his Swachh Bharat campaign in Aligarh. Rahul also addressed rallies in Mathura and Kanpur. Home Minister and BJP leader Rajnath Singh also addressed voters in Mathura, Hathras, Gautam Buddha Nagar and Baghpat. Speaking at a rally, he attacked the Akhilesh Yadav government for the poor law and order situation in Uttar Pradesh. Well, joining me for a chat this evening to talk about the elections in Uttar Pradesh is Manish Chibbar, Chief of Bureau, Indian Express. Thank you so much for joining me on the program. Manish Chibbar, as far as this particular phase of polling is concerned that will be held, for which the campaigning has come to an end, who do you believe has the edge?
You know, because this is a predominant large section of Muslim population, so the contest will be between Mayawati's BSP and the Samajwadi Party Congress Alliance. These elections are also being held under the shadow of, we all remember what happened in Dadri over that beef issue and Muzaffarnagar riots. So during our travels in these areas, we saw that people had not forgotten these things. So I would say that, these two, the Alliance and BSP, the fight in these areas, voting where voting will take place day after tomorrow, the fight is between these two parties.
Indeed. And what do you believe are the issues that are going to dominate the polls that will be held day after tomorrow in Western UP?
You know, Akhilesh, in the run-up to this assembly election, he's very smartly portrayed himself as somebody, as a politician who believes in development, and he's not taking seeking votes in the name of his this Jat or Gujar alliance or even the Muslims. He's not basically going in for that. So all that he's telling the voters is that here am I, a young face of a political party which hitherto was known more for its caste-centric politics. So So, but I am coming to you as a politician, as a chief minister who has done something for the state. And, you know, and because of the incidents leading up to these elections, especially the fight within the Samajwadi Party, he has very, you know, craftily managed to pitch himself as the face of development in UP. And this runs counter to what the BJP has been doing so far, because, you know, we all know Prime Minister Modi, he also keeps on talking about development. In fact, wherever he, in his election rallies, wherever he goes in UP, he's been talking of that, how, you know, in the last 30 years, no development worth its name has happened in UP because there has been a non-BJP government. So he wants to change that. Mayawati, you know, wherever we've followed her campaign or the campaign of the BSP, we have come to understand that, you know, her main plank continues to be that under her regime, because before 2012 when she was in power, the UP, she says, was a much better place to live in. The Gunda elements, most of whom she claims owe their allegiance to the Samajwadi Party, she says that I kept them under a check.
Indeed. All right. Do stay with us. I'm going to come back to you for another reaction on the other story that you're tracking here as well. Now, Chief Election Commissioner Naseem Zaidi and his team reviewed poll preparations for the third and fourth phase of assembly elections in Uttar Pradesh. During his two-day visit, Zaidi met officers of enforcement agencies. The commission also met representatives of political parties to seek their feedback on election preparedness. 69 constituencies will vote in the third phase on the 19th of February, and elections for 53 seats will take place on the 23rd of February.
एक मुख्य बिंदु हमारी पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज का था कि जो उत्तर प्रदेश में केंद्रीय सुरक्षा बल दिए गए हैं उनको पोलिंग स्टेशन पर तैनात किया जाए और उनके रूट मार्चेस वगैरह जो हमारे कमजोर वर्गों के लोग हैं या जहां पर वोटरों को डराए धमकाने की बात है वहां पर उनका कराया जाए। हमने अपने इलेक्शन ऑफिशियल्स को ये निर्देश भी दे दिए हैं कि वो हमारे आचार संहिता का अनुपालन और उसका कार्यान्वयन बिना किसी भेदभाव के, बिना किसी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी में डिस्क्रिमिनेट किए हुए, उसका इम्प्लीमेंटेशन सुनिश्चित करें।
Well, campaigning in poll-bound Uttarakhand peaked today with star candidates travelling the length and breadth of the state to reach out to voters. While Congress is going to the polls with a definite face in Harish Rawat, the BJP has left people guessing about who would get the top office if the latter is voted to power.
Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi and Uttarakhand Chief Minister Harish Rawat on Thursday addressed campaign rallies in Almora and Sitarganj district of the state. While Rawat cautioned people against voting for leaders who deserted the Congress to join the BJP, Rahul Gandhi targeted Prime Minister Narendra Modi, accusing him of hurting the tourism sector by imposing demonetization.
Manmohan Singh ji ne 10 saal is desh ke liye kaam kiya. Shayad pehle hi pradhanmantri hai Narendra Modi ji.
BJP President Amit Shah also campaigned in Uttarakhand on Thursday. Addressing a rally in New Tihri district, the BJP President criticized the Harish Rawat government and supported Prime Minister Narendra Modi for his raincoat jibe against former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh in the Rajya Sabha.
Hare Rawat ji, drishti honi chahiye. अब आप रहने दीजिए, आपका समय समाप्त हो चुका है। 11 तारीख को आपकी विदाई तय है। हम बताते हैं कैसे पहाड़ियों पर रोजगारी दी जा सकती है।
बीएसपी सुप्रीमो मायावती ऑल्सो एड्रेस्ड अ रैली इन लक्सर टाउन ऑफ हरिद्वार डिस्ट्रिक्ट। Addressing the crowd, Mayawati accused both the Congress and the BJP of trying to do away with the reservation system.
वैसे आप लोगों को ये मालूम है किन वर्गों के लोगों को बाबा साहब डॉक्टर अंबेडकर के अथक प्रयासों के कारण जब भारतीय संविधान ने शिक्षा, सरकारी नौकरियों व राजनीति आदि में जो भी आरक्षण की सुविधाएं मिली हैं तो उन्हें भी अब यहाँ एक सोची समझी साजिश के तहत ही निष्प्रभावी बनाने व धीरे धीरे खत्म करने का भी प्रयास किया जा रहा है।
Uttarakhand goes to polls on February 15th, where the Harish Rawat government faces a stiff challenge from the BJP. 5 days are left for the end of campaigning in the state. Counting of votes is scheduled to take place on March 11th. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, let me go back to my guest, Manish Chibbar, Chief of Bureau, Indian Express, once again to get a reaction on Uttarakhand as well. You know, as far as Uttarakhand is concerned, it's just got 6 more days for the state to go to polls. But campaigning has been somewhat subdued this time around, still not reached a fever pitch.
You know, campaigning is happening at actually a very feverish pitch there. But unfortunately, you know, since at the same time we are having elections, earlier we had Punjab and now we are having UP simultaneously. So the focus is on UP now. But, you know, from whatever reports we are getting there, both sides are making, doing their best to ensure that voters place their faith in them rather than the other party. And, you know, Harish Rawat government, it's facing massive anti-incumbency. While the BJP is itself a divided house, majorly because of the large number of candidates that it has borrowed from the Congress.
Sure. All right. We'll have to leave to that. Thank you so much, Manish Chibbar, for joining us on the program and putting things into perspective for us. Moving on now. With election fever gripping the hill state of Uttarakhand, capital city Dehradun has become the nerve center of all political activity. The state will vote in a single phase on February 15th with a straight contest between the two traditional rivals, the Congress and the BJP. Though less in number, smaller parties too can make the contest tight in a 70-seat assembly. Here's a look at some of the focus issues.
Whether it is the queen of hill stations Mussoorie or the spiritual Rishikesh, preparations for the assembly polls are being seen all across the capital city. The polls are also an opportunity to bring the focus back on local issues, be it in the news or daily conversations. This time round, the issue of migrations from hilly areas remains high on focus, especially that of lack of basic amenities and facilities like jobs and shoddy management of education, health, roadways and transport.
जगह जगह सीवर लाइन खुद ये भरने का नाम नहीं ले रहे हैं। सरकार कर क्या रही है? स्वास्थ्य के प्रति किसी को लापरवाही हो रही है। आए दिन आप देखते हैं पहाड़ में तरह तरह की समस्याएं हो रही हैं। स्वास्थ्य और रोजगार का सबसे बड़ा मुद्दा है, इसको देख के हम वोट करेंगे।
कॉलेज में CBCS सिस्टम लागू किया गया है। CBCS सिस्टम के तहत में स्किल के कोर्सेज आए हैं, तो उसमें हर स्किल के कोर्सेज के हिसाब से अलग से टीचर्स होते हैं स्किल के, जिसमें टीचर्स की कमी है, तो हम चाहते हैं कॉलेज में टीचर्स की कमी भी।
The irony of Uttarakhand lies in its beauty, a boon for tourists, but a bane for the locals. Entrepreneurs and job seekers want to encourage tourism, but the facilities are abysmal. The hope this time is to get a government that understands the troubles of the hill people and stop entire villages from emptying out.
हमारे यहाँ अस्पताल की दिक्कत है, अस्पताल हमारे यहाँ आसपास नहीं है, 10 किलोमीटर अस्पताल है, जो वहाँ जाने में दिक्कत पड़ जाती है। दूसरा, हमारे यहाँ जो है आसपास फैक्ट्रियां जो अभी हैं, सब में बाहर कहीं रोजगार दिया जाता है, यहाँ पे कुछ फैक्ट्रियां लगनी चाहिए ताकि ग्रामवासियों को रोजगार मिल सके।
बीइंग अ स्टूडेंट, मैं ये चाहती हूँ कि जो भी यहाँ पे सरकार आए, वो हम यूथ के लिए, हम स्टूडेंट के लिए सबसे पहले तो एडुकेशन लोन को लेके कुछ हमें प्रोवाइड करवाए। सेकेंड, यहाँ पे स्किल डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम हम यूथ के लिए लेकर आए। थर्ड, यहाँ पे तीसरी चीज ये लेकर आए कि यहाँ पे स्कूल्स वगैरह ज्यादा बने, कॉलेज वगैरह ज्यादा बने।
Dehradun district consists of 10 assembly seats, which is expected to witness a keen contest between the ruling party Congress and the main challenger BJP. In the 2012 assembly polls, both the parties had shared the honours, scoring victories on 5 seats. Congress won Chakrata, Vikas Nagar, Dharmpur, Raipur and Rajpur Road, while the BJP got Sahaspur, Mussoorie, Doiwala, Dehradun Cant and Rishikesh. The situation this time, though, seems to be different, with rebellion hitting both camps. Navikram Singh's report for Rajya Sabha Television.
Moving on now, repolling was held at 48 polling stations in 5 districts of Punjab on Thursday. The districts included Amritsar, Moga, Muktsar, Mansa and Sangrur. इलेक्शन कमीशन हैड ऑर्डर रीपोलिंग फॉलोइंग मैलफंक्शनिंग ऑफ वोटर वेरीफाइड पेपर ऑडिट ट्रेल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वोटिंग मशीन्स इन दीज स्टेशंस ड्यूरिंग पोलिंग ऑन फरवरी 4th. Polling was conducted at 14 polling stations in Amritsar parliamentary constituency, 12 in Majita, 1 in Moga, 9 in Muktsar, 4 in Sardulgarh and 6 in Sangrur assembly segment. Besides, 9 polling stations are in Muktsar, 6 in Sangrur, 4 in Sardulgarh and 1 in Moga. The vote count will take place on March 11th.
इलेक्शन कमीशन का फैसला है जी, मैं उदा स्वागत करदा। उन्होंने कुछ जापिया होना, उन्होंने कुछ कमी पेशी उन्होंने प्रोसेस च दिखी होनी। उन्होंने रीपोल ऑर्डर की है, कुदरती वह बूथ च भी होगी जिथे बड़ा लम्मा समा मशीन बंद रही सी। तुसी आप उस दिन आए सी ते मैं बगैर वोट पा के मुड़ना पिया सीगा, फिर बाद च आके वोट कास्ट की है। इसलिए आई वेलकम जो इलेक्शन कमीशन के फैसले उन्होंने किए है।
Well, here's a roundup of all the other election-related news in Polpuri. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Akhilesh Yadav today sacked Uttar Pradesh Minister Sharda Pratap Shukla for contesting UP Assembly elections on a Rashtriya Lok Dal ticket. Shukla, sitting MLA from Sarojini Nagar seat in the state capital, was denied SP ticket, after which he filed his nomination on an RLD ticket. SP had given the ticket to Mulayam Singh Yadav's nephew Anurag Yadav. SP chief spokesman Rajendra Chaudhary said that Shukla has also been expelled from the party for indulging in anti-party activities. The nominations for the 7th and final phase of Uttar Pradesh assembly polls started today, with the notification for 40 assembly seats spread across 7 districts. Polling will be held on the 8th of March. The districts going to polls are Jaunpur, Varanasi, Ghazipur, Mirzapur, Chandoli, Sonbhadra and Bhadohi. Nominations will continue till the 16th of February. The scrutiny of papers would be on the 17th of February, while candidates can withdraw their papers till February 20th. The counting of votes will be held on March 11th. Defence Minister Manohar Parikar is likely to reply to Election Commission for his alleged remarks. Election Commission has issued a notice to Defence Minister Manohar Parikar for his alleged remarks asking people to accept money from others but vote for the BJP. Earlier replying to the EC's first notice, Parikar said that his words were wrongly translated and also questioned the authenticity of the CD related to his speech made during the campaign for Goa Assembly polls. In its fresh notice, the poll body rejected the BJP leader's contentions, maintaining that the CD is authentic. With neighbouring Uttar Pradesh voting in the first phase of assembly elections on Saturday, dry days will be observed in Delhi from today until February 11th in 100-metre radius of the border points. The first phase of elections will be held in neighbouring Ghaziabad, Noida districts on February 11th. Let's now shift focus to Agra, where water scarcity is reaching alarming proportions. Water is being pumped up from underground sources and used for domestic as well as irrigation purposes. And in several parts of the city, the water is high on fluoride content and contains high volume of heavy metals, causing severe medical problems. Here's a report.
Of the 500 odd villagers in Agra's Rohta village, around 95 have bone deformities. The area is plagued by skeletal fluorosis, a physical deformity caused by excess fluoride content in drinking water. Shambhu, a carpenter by profession, faces a daily struggle to make ends meet. His entire family suffers from the debilitating disease. His wife Shanti too has severely deformed bones in the legs, a condition that developed when she was just 6 months old. And now both her legs are bent inwards at the knee.
इस खराब पानी वजह से हमारा ये हाल हुआ है, और हम चाहते हैं कि हमारे बच्चों का ये हाल ना हो खराब पानी से.
In many parts of Agra, fluoride in drinking water is far higher than the permissible limit of 1.5 mg. This has left hundreds of residents parched, waiting in long queue for safe drinking water. Ruksana and other residents of this village barely manage a bucket of water each day.
पहली बार तो पानी नहीं आता है, और आता भी है तो गंदा पानी आता है, किसी मतलब का नहीं आता है. ज्यादा ज्यादा कपड़े धो लो या फैला लो बस, और कीचड़ आती है बिल्कुल सड़ी बदबू मारती है बुरी तरीके से. इतनी समस्या पानी की, पीने का तो मतलब कहीं नहीं है बिल्कुल पानी। अब बताओ क्या हो।
Conventional water treatment methods as well as the first phase of Yamuna action plan have not managed to check the high pollution levels at Agra. By the time the Yamuna enters Agra district, it was reduced to a sewage canal and a substantial quantity of river water is lifted by the farmers for irrigating their fields. Unless authorities desilt and dredge the river, the underground water problems will not abate, while another election may just pass by.
Despite several directives from the Supreme Court and the National Green Tribunal, the Delhi-Agra stretch of Yamuna remains the most polluted. Several crores have been pumped in, both by the central government and the state government, but a solution looks distant. The government needs to finalize an explicit roadmap to mitigate the water woes of the Taj city. Reporting from Agra, with cameraperson Shiv Kumar and Kriti Mishra for Radhya Sabha Television.
That's it on this edition of Verdict 2017. Have a good evening.